It's very clear that a universal quantum computer will need millions of entangled qubits and employ error correction to be useful. But having that many qubits all at once is just not feasible. So, what's the solution? Using photons as qubits allows spreading these millions of qubits over multiple generations along the timeline of the computation, so that only hundreds of them are generated at each instant. To better understand how this can be achieved, let's take a look at the general layout of such a computer. It all starts here with these resource state generators, RSGs, that repeatedly produce small clusters of entangled photons. These clusters are then delivered to stitching devices that entangle them to each other, resulting in a huge cluster of entangled qubits. But we don't stop there. We also want these clusters to be entangled with states that will be produced later in time. That's where the delay loops come in. These are essentially long fibers that act as a quantum memory. By using delay loops, we can send some of the photons to be stored and arrive later at the stitching device. This way, they can be entangled with clusters from later clock cycles. By repeating this method with many RSGs and lots of stitching devices, we can create a massive cluster of entangled qubits that are fed to an array of detectors slice by slice. A classical computer determines the exact sequence of measurements to achieve the desired quantum algorithm. Think of it like weaving a fabric of quantum information, where the waveguides provide the framework. We can keep adding more photonic clusters, like threads to a tapestry, to create a computation as large as required. With this approach, we can perform a million qubit error-corrected calculation with only hundreds of qubits generated at each time, thus making the universal quantum computer a reality.